We're going to do some of my favorite stuff today right here on the Six Figure Mastermind. I'm going to give you a peek on my screen on how to actually compose an email through Mailchimp. Stay tuned and check it out. Hey, let's talk mass mailing. Now, if you're in business for yourself, you've probably grown a bit of a list, which is a consumer list, a customer list, however you want to put it, and you need to contact them. You need to be able to send emails out to your people. And so how do we do that? You know, you've got your standard email platform, which could be Google, it could be Yahoo, it could be Outlook, or whatever you're using. And most likely with that system, you're not able to send several bulk emails out every single day. And I know with Gmail specifically, you can send up to 500 out a day. And if you need to send, if you've got a list that's, you know, 1,200 people or 5,000 people, if you've got a list longer than 500 and you need to send emails out to all of them, you're pretty much in trouble with Gmail. So that's why you need Mailchimp. You know, there's lots of different mail servers out there. I'm going to talk about Mailchimp today because it's the one I use. And it's really great for beginning business people because they have a free platform where you're able to send more than 500 emails out a day. You can send thousands of emails out to thousands of people, and you probably won't need to. Don't get spammy on me. But you've got an option to not only get the emails out there, but there's Mailchimp actually gives you lots of information on the back end that none of the Gmail or Outlook or Yahoo affiliations or programs, they won't do that for you. Mailchimp will. So you'll be able to see lots of information about how many emails were opened, how many clicks you have, how many people were redirected to websites, what they're looking at. You've got this A-B split test you can do. And in our other videos, we're going to go really in depth into everything you can do with Mailchimp. But let's get started just today looking at what it looks like to actually compose an email. So if you actually look at my screen right here, you're going to see, good morning, Marianne. We're ready to start off your day with some amazing emails and stats and recommendations. And you'll see a little bit of my back end list. But let's just start out with actually composing an email. Now, in Mailchimp, they call these campaigns. An email is a campaign with a Mailchimp. So you're going to create a campaign. That's what you need to do to brand new get started. Okay. So once you click create campaign, it's going to take you to this amazing, really cool template setup. Now, you don't have to know coding. You don't have to know HTML or C++. I don't even know all the codings out there. I don't even know what they are, but neither do you. You don't need to know them to send really cool quality emails. So let's create this email and we'll just walk you through the guide process, okay? Mailchimp is really great about creating a very user-friendly interface. So I'm going to walk you through that user-friendly interface to get your campaign out the door. Okay, so we got to decide first, what do we want to do? Do we want to create an email, create an ad, or create a landing page? Today, we're going to walk through creating an email. So let's go ahead and click that and get started. Now, your campaign name, remember with Mailchimp, campaign and email, they're synonymous, they're interchangeable. You want to keep your subscribers engaged by sharing your latest news, promoting online of products, or announcing an event. Your campaign name is something that you're going to want to be very specific on so you remember exactly what you're sending out to your emails. And when you're going back and looking at the data, you remember what the email contained without having to go in and look at the entire body of the email. So today we're going to do test campaign for Six Figure Mastermind. Make sure you spell everything correctly. That's always handy. Okay, begin. Click begin. It's going to take you to a brand new page. We're going to decide who we want to send this to, where we want it to appear that it's coming from, what's the subject line for this campaign. Remember, the name of your campaign and the subject, two different things, okay? And then the content of your email. So let's decide who we want to send this campaign to. If you're using Mailchimp, you should have already uploaded your email list either with a CSV format, or sometimes you can set up Mailchimp to just talk to your email and auto upload all the emails for you. So once you've set that up, and again, you can check out our other videos on how to do that, and you'll be able to add these recipients right here. So if you click add recipients, you can then select from your list who you want this to go to. Now, Mailchimp is so cool because you can actually divide up all of your emails into lists. So maybe you have an event that you put together and you have everyone that came to that event set up in a list. You can email just that list if you want. Or maybe you have a list of everyone that lives in a certain demographic, geographically or, you know, lifestyle-wise. You can segment your emails to talk to just that list. So you can pick a list here. For this, we are just going to talk to, let's talk to our workshop. We have 503 people that came to our workshop, so I'm going to choose that list. Now you can segment this list. Check this out. You can segment this list to new subscribers, active, inactive, potential, recent, first-time customers, repeat, female, male, under 35, 35 and older. This is a new feature put together by Mailchimp to help you get more centralized in your list. The more specific you are, the more effective your email campaigns are, okay? So I'm just going to say all subscribers on the list for this test, okay? Personalize the to field. What's this? You can personalize the to field by putting in their first name, their last name, first and last name, or custom. You know, if you have a list where not everyone's name is included on your list, don't use this feature, because if you don't have a first name, it's going to show, hey, F name, and no one wants to be called F name or L name or whatever it is. So if you know that you're missing some of the first names on your list, don't use this feature, okay? You can always do a custom one, and you can say, hey, there. That's pretty safe, albeit impersonal. So bottom line is, get all the names for the people on your list. You just want to have everyone covered, okay? For this one, we're just going to be very general. Okay, from who is sending this campaign? This is very, very important. It may be obvious to you that it's coming from you, but it's not always obvious to your customers. I mean, think about it. How often in your email do you check and, you know, make sure that you know where all the emails are coming from, and how many of those people do you recognize and remember? You don't always do that. So be very, very clear. So you can change who this is coming from. I own another photography business. That's the old name for it. So I would say this email, since it's an email for the six-figure mastermind test, would be coming from Marianne DeNovellis at, and you can change who the email comes from too, okay? You can say six-figure mastermind at gmail.com. Now it's a real email address. It won't take it if it's not a real email address. Make sure it's legit, okay? All right, save that. Boom, that's done. Subject, what's the subject line for this campaign? Now, there's a really, really important aspect to remember when it comes to subject lines. And always think of it as yourself as a consumer when you're thinking of subject lines. What do you want to open when you see your email? Does it include emojis? Does it include a question? Does it include, you know, there's a whole spectrum of great subject lines that you can look up. And in fact, we'll do a video on how to create a great subject line for your email. But, you know, just pick one for this. And remember that your readers aren't going to read your entire subject line if it's really, really long. So it does give you a preview text on what your subject line will actually look like. And of course, you want your subject line to be relevant to the body of your email. So if I put this in there, it's going to have to relate to the body of my email. Something cool that I found online, some new idea that I put together, some new concept that I read from a book or saw at a seminar. I'm going to be sharing that with them in the body of the email because my subject line pretty much says I will. So that's just good customer relations right there. So I'll put a little ellipse in there. Okay, how do I write a good subject line? Mailchimp also gives you some support there. Emoji support. Emoji characters are well supported in many client emails, especially on mobiles, but they don't show up everywhere. So you'll be able to use Mailchimp to kind of define which emojis you want to use and which emojis you kind of won't want to use, because it'll just show up as a little box if you put that in your email and it's not supported. Okay, so that's going to show up. We're in a happy place here. Preview text. This snippet will appear in the inbox after the subject line. So this preview text, you can use it. You don't have to use it. Preview text could look like, I could say, I went to my 57th seminar and found an amazing idea. Okay, maybe that's your subject line. Just make it cohesive, make it coherent, all right? Cohesive and coherent. Here we go. I'm going to click save that. No, never guess what I found. Now, your preview text won't always show up, depending on if you're on desktop or mobile, in whoever's using desktop or mobile. So make sure that that preview text and the subject line text aren't dependent on each other. They may not see that preview text. They may only see the subject line. So make sure the subject line isn't dependent on the preview text, okay? Then you're gonna get into content. Now this deserves its whole other video, so make sure that you check in and watch for our content building, but this is just the basic walkthrough. You know, you wanna have great imagery in there, great photography in there, but this is the custom tailoring that Mailchimp provides, okay? So you can do, you wanna sell a product, make an announcement, tell a story, follow up, educate. Pick any of these things, or you can just pick a basic template and pick one with you images. I always recommend sending an email with images every single time because it's just visually appealing, okay? You can pick your columns, you can pick your full width, or you can just send a simple text email. Again, I would always recommend something with a picture because that's just eye-catching. It's appealing. That's what people want to see, okay? So you can pick, again, one of these products right here. You can pick one of the basic templates. Today, let's just pick the first basic template. You're gonna fill this template in with pictures and text and content. You can drop an image that you have on your computer, or you can browse and use one of their stock photos. You know, for this demonstration, I've got several images that I've sent out for clients, so it's gonna save my images from previous emails. Let's just, you know, pick something pretty over here. Okay, so this is an image that I shot during a photo shoot from a designer who was designing wedding invitations. So, you know, I would, obviously this is going to be very specific to that. I could use this image to promote something, or I could use this image to just be a stock photo. Maybe I'll write something about writing letters in here. Okay, in the body of my email, I'm going to click this edit symbol. And then I'm gonna actually edit on the right side of the screen. So you can design everything in here. You can design your style, your font, your size, all of these things, centered, justified, left, right, all of this is in there. You can even attach links if you wanna do that using this little HTML right here. You can link to other websites using this little tag right here to link. And you can see, you know, this already has one built in. You wanna delete that and start over. So you just, you know, take a moment, highlight the whole thing, and delete what they have. Let's see if we can highlight the entire thing here. Okay, it's gonna auto-format, so just, you know, be aware that you'll have that to work with. Okay, so test email. Here's the cool thing that I learned at the seminar. It was really amazing. Blah, blah, value, value. Okay, now this email may or may not have a call to action. That's up to you. At the bottom of this email, you're going to have social media links. If you have those social media links in your email, double check and make sure that they're sending people to your actual social media links. So if you don't have a Twitter account, you better delete that feature, okay? If you don't have a Facebook page, you better delete that. If you don't have a website, you better delete that. If you do, put your links in this text box right here, okay? Make sure the link is filled up. Make sure the link text is filled up. Link text could just simply say, join our Facebook community, and so on. So double check all of those. Again, you double check every box, okay? This copyright, if you send it as it is, it's just gonna send this text, copyright, current year, list company, all rights reserved, okay? Clean this up. Make sure it's clean top to bottom in your email, okay? So sometimes I'll just delete this. Something that your email absolutely has to have is a unsubscribe button. That's just common courtesy in the industry, and MailChimp really likes it when you do that. So make sure you have the unsubscribe, keep it in there, okay? And MailChimp will take care of your unsubscribes for you. It'll make sure that you're not sending emails to people that have unsubscribes. You know, for one thing, you know, it's just good customer service to not send emails to people that have unsubscribed from your list. For another thing, it just avoids any hairy situations, okay? So we're gonna double check our email top to bottom here. You can view this email in your browser if you're ready to go. If you're happy with it, save and close, okay? Then you're gonna save and close this whole portion and move on to the next page. So you've got your content, you've got your to, you've got your from. Okay, with the free version of MailChimp, they are going to add a MailChimp badge to the bottom of your email. Just be aware of that. And you've got your connection with Facebook and Twitter. You got your tracking and settings all set up here. You can go in and edit those. But Now comes the special magic time, okay? It is time to send this campaign. You click the send button, then it's like got this little monkey hand that's like all nervous and sweating, and is it time to send my campaign, okay? I'm not gonna click send this now because this is a testing, and if I send this to my workshop list, they're gonna be like, what the heck are you doing? But once you click this send now button, that's the moment of truth. That email is out there. It is ready for the public to see, ready for the public to open. And MailChimp's gonna track all of your data and all of your information. And we'll walk through how to do that in another video. We're gonna show you all things MailChimp. But just stay tuned, check in with your MailChimp. You know, be aware of this. Keep your finger on the pulse of your emails and go back in and follow up and make sure that your people are getting responses. You know, MailChimp can do an autoresponder for you as well. Or it can just have it simply sent to your current email box and you can reply to people that way. So that's basically it. Sending an email with MailChimp is very simple. MailChimp has a great interface to use. It's free on most levels and it always has a very reasonably priced upgrade for you if you need to send out more emails than MailChimp has available. I hope you enjoy it. Feel free to rewatch this over and over and over again with as many emails as you need to compose. Just go ahead and fill us in. In fact, drop a comment below. Tell us your favorite feature that you've discovered on MailChimp. We'll see you tomorrow.